Hi, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Weather. We experience weather every day. Sometimes it's sunny, other times it's cloudy. It can also be windy, rainy, and snowy, my favorite. And sometimes we have storms with thunder and lightning. We cannot control the weather, but we can learn about it. Ready to storm through different weather conditions with me? Let's do it! To understand the weather, we need to learn about Earth's water cycle. A lot of people think rain comes from clouds, and this is true, but did you know that rain starts from bodies of water like oceans, lakes, rivers, streams? It does. In the water cycle, water evaporates or turns from liquid into vapor. It does this because of a change in temperature or because of a change in air pressure. The water form from oceans, rivers, or lakes rises from the Earth's surface in the form of vapor, which is a gas, into the Earth's atmosphere. The atmosphere is layers of gases that surround the Earth. Weather happens in this layer of the atmosphere called the troposphere. Evaporation happens all the time without realizing it. Do you ever hang your wet swimsuit out to dry in the sun? When your swimsuit goes from wet to dry, it's because the sun heats the water in the suit and it evaporates into vapor. The same is true for your wet hair after swimming or wet soil in your garden when the sun heats it after a rainfall. Do you know what water vapor becomes once it's in the atmosphere? Yes! When water vapor cools and condenses, it becomes a cloud. Condensation happens when the water vapor becomes liquid again and forms clouds. When too much water has condensed or turned into liquid droplets, the clouds become very heavy. That's when water falls back down to the ground, called precipitation. Precipitation is a big word that really means rain, snow, hail, or sleet. It's the liquid and water particles that fall from the clouds onto the ground. But why does precipitation sometimes come down as rain, other times as snow or hail or sleet? Let's look at this process more closely. Rain is water vapor from the air that condenses and falls as water droplets. It provides water for plants and animals, it helps a garden grow, and it helps fill ponds and streams. When light reflects on water droplets in the air, it creates a colorful spectrum called a rainbow. In hot weather, you might hear adults talk about humidity. Humidity is water vapor in the air, and it makes your skin feel moist. Do you know that fog is cloud in the air near the ground? Yes! When you wake up on a foggy day, you're actually in a cloud. On summer mornings, you might wake up and find that the grass is wet without having rained or without the sprinklers being on. That's because during the night, the air is cool and the water vapor in the air condenses onto the ground and the plants. This moist surface it creates is called dew. Now, snow is water droplets in the sky that freeze into ice crystals before they fall to the ground. This happens when temperatures are so cold in the layers between the clouds and the Earth's surface. Those snow crystals, or snowflakes, are unique. Even though every snowflake has 6 points, no two snowflakes are alike. A major winter storm consists of a lot of snow, freezing temperatures, and high-speed winds. Sometimes water droplets in the clouds don't come down as raindrops or snowflakes. Sometimes they are ice pellets. When the snow melts in a warm layer and then refreezes into ice as it comes through a cold layer, it is known as sleet. When the water droplets freeze in warmer temperatures, like in spring or summer, they come down as hail. Hail is usually formed in the clouds during thunderstorms. Thunderstorms happen when warm, moist air moves upward really fast. When this fast-moving air cools and condenses, this then becomes clouds. The water droplets can sometimes become ice. As the ice pellets come down, they bump into other ice pellets and other water droplets, and they become larger ice pellets until the cloud can no longer hold them at all, and they fall like hail on the Earth's surface. The more they bump around, the bigger the hailstorm. Thunderstorms and lightning go hand in hand. Lightning happens during every thunderstorm. You cannot have thunder without lightning. Lightning is electricity produced by all of those ice pellets in the sky that bump into each other. They create electrical charges that eventually fill up the entire cloud. Then that cloud charge connects with a huge charge on the earth, like trees or the ground, and then zap, lightning strikes. Zzz, ouch! Have you ever rubbed your feet on a rug and then touched a metal doorknob or something and it zaps you? Yikes! It's just like lightning. Lightning can be as hot as 54,000 degrees Fahrenheit. Fahrenheit is a scale used to measure temperature. That's how we in the USA record daily weather temperatures. But most countries use the centigrade scale and record temperature in Celsius. The Kelvin scale is another scale used to measure temperature. You know that lightning is nearby when you hear thunder, because thunder is the sound that lightning makes. When a lightning bolt strikes from cloud to cloud, it actually opens up a hole in the air. Once the light disappears, the hole closes up and makes a crashing sound called thunder. Boom! Crash! Did you know that the expression lightning never strikes the same spot twice is actually a myth? That means it's not true. Lightning can hit a spot twice, either during the same storm or hundreds of years later. Weather is so fascinating, which is why so many people work with or around weather. A person who studies weather is called a meteorologist, and the person who gives the weather forecast is called a weather forecaster. You have seen these forecasters on TV. Farmers count on favorable weather conditions for the growth of their crops. Maybe the adults you live with check a weather app daily before planning a trip or a picnic. You can now better understand what forecasters are talking about when they describe this week's conditions. Practice what you learned about the weather on our fun online games and quizzes. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.